Hello, my name is Mehdi, and I'm from Amsterdam.
You wanna hot body, you wanna Bugatti, you wanna Maserati, you better work, bitch. You wanna Lamborghini, sit in martinis, look hot in a bikini. You better work, bitch. You wanna live fancy, live in a big mansion, party in France. You better work, bitch. You better work, bitch.
Have your baby daddy yet? Your ass out of this company swapping to a different nationality. I decided to come to London like 6 months ago because I couldn't find a university of my choice in Amsterdam and I was tired of the city. The city could not handle me, so I came to London. I came here to study, to have an international education, to meet new people, to change my life and start clean, sober, and healthy, and for the raves, of course. And I'm really happy here. I really love London. The streets are alive. Like, it's a very diverse and amazing city, and I'm having a lot of fun. Meet great people, some of them are not so great, but still, I'm grateful. Well, I have a lot of experiences, some of them cannot be mentioned, because they're rated S. So far, my most amazing experience was in Amsterdam. It was a cold December night. I was drunk and wasted as hell. And then I went to the red light district in my pajamas and my flip-flops and it was minus 13. And I started screaming at the prostitutes when I was drunk and then I got arrested for public scandal. I wouldn't say I have a specific sexuality. I'm like the word sexuality because, you know, when someone is gay, straight or bisexual, just like they're putting a label on the person. I just consider myself human and I see beauty in both genders. Well, I'm attracted to whatever gets in the way. I don't have a preference if it's boys or girls. I like them all the same. Thing is, about weird thing about my sexuality is some people call me bisexual, but I don't know if that's true or not because I've only been in love with a woman. I've never been in love with a man. I met with a transsexual once. Whatever I do when I'm drunk or intoxicated is not what I'm. The stories you heard. That's not me. Well, the most irritating story is the story that, you know, that took place in my dorm. I didn't know the guy had a girlfriend and, you know, well, I actually knew, she's my friend, but still, I wanted to give her a try. My mother. I wanted to piss her off, so that's my inspiration. Mind the tongue one because it was not visible, but when I realized that she didn't get pissed enough, I got my chin pierced. I was gonna get my eyebrow done. I didn't want to be kicked out of the house, so. When I got them, she told me that I looked like a male prostitute, but she, you know, she got over it eventually. I didn't say anything when she got her boob job, so what would she judge me if I have piercings? Yo, I read, I write. Well, it's not that I don't believe in love, but you know, I just think that love is an emotion that makes humans vulnerable and weak. And it seems quite enjoyable, but I've never heard, you know, all that things work into love. I write journalistic and fiction articles and poems. I like dark gothic poetry. Because, you know, I'm from Amsterdam and techno is in my blood and I love clubbing, I love going to raves, I love meeting people. I love having fun and making up for the time I wasted when I was younger and enjoy it to the fullest. Of course, we all have those situations in love when you feel really lost and you find yourself in the middle of nowhere and like you have no exit out of your problems and sometimes you end up making the wrong decisions, but that's part of life. I'm a hopeless romantic. Yeah, and I can cook very well. I already cooked one day for the boys in Montfort and they really loved it. But then we got arrested and it wasn't that fun. Well, because apparently my retarded roommate has a retarded friend. And the retarded friend was very high and was smoking a joint and we were with him. I wasn't smoking, obviously. And then the police came out of the middle of nowhere and they busted him. And he didn't want to give the joint to the policeman because he was too high and he started telling him stories about his mom was a diplomat and blah blah blah. And then, you know, they had to let me go because I started flirting with the policeman and it really worked, but the other two got in trouble. Well, I haven't traveled a lot. Well, I've traveled a lot across Europe, but, you know, since I have a very busy on the run life and my mom is always traveling and everything, and, you know, can't travel alone, like, I'm I'm 21 and I never traveled alone in my life. Like, it was my first time traveling alone, and I took my mom dropped me to the airport. She helped me out until I got on the plane. And then when I arrived to London, I got lost in the airport for 2.5 hours because I didn't know what a terminal is. And then I had to take a black cab from Heathrow till Richmond station because I thought the passport was open and it was a Sunday. So I had to take another cab back home. It cost me a fortune. But, you know, and I really like Europe. I don't see myself living in any other continent. I like Japan. Like, my dream place to go is Japan. I'm fascinated by the culture. And, you know, I also want to go to New York. If I don't end up living in London, I would end up living in New York. A little party never killed nobody. Pledge allegiance to the struggle. Ain't been easy, but she's the peasy. For the weeks we lived out in Duffel. Bags is all we had doing. A thing for my mom, I love you. One day I'll pay you back for the sacrifice that you... I enjoy partying a lot. I enjoy raves. I enjoy raving. Like, I like techno and electronic dance music and being around and just freeing yourself and get high from the music and just, you know, do whatever you want. I was a lucky guy that I've always been stuck.